They will take up the appeals under the CPC. There are various appeals under the Code of Civil Procedure Code. There are appeals from the original decree. There are appeals from the appellate decree. And there are appeals from the orders, interlocutory orders, which are affecting the rights of the parties. Now, since this interlocutory appeals and orders are filed during the pendency of a suit. Now, since we had dealt earlier the interlocutory order pending the suit, now we will take up the appeals first from the interlocutory order. Okay? Then we'll go for the appeal from the decree under section 96 onwards. Now this appeal from orders, the relevant provisions are, number one, section 104. If you can open this, section 104. And order 43. First, we'll deal with the section 104. Now, this 104 and order 43 applies to all the civil courts. Now, there was a conflicting opinion as to whether the provisions of section 104, order 43 also applies to high court orders. Because you know that high court has got a separate provision with regard to filing of the suits and appeals that is called letters patent. The relevant provision in the letters patent for appeal is clause 15. I will deal with it. Let us first deal with section 104 before I come to letters patent. Now, an appeal shall lie from the following orders. It says, number one, double F, yahan pe A, B, C, D, sab nikal diya gaya. An order under section 35A. Now, 35A, you have learned an order to pass compensatory cause, which we learned earlier. If you can open briefly section 35A, the student will be benefited. That deals with the provision for passing compensatory costs by the court when the defenses are incorrect, when the suit is filed is not proper. The court has wide powers to pass orders, compensatory costs. When there are vexatious claim, false claim in respect of the cases. Now, when this order is passed by the court, it is an appealable order under 104. Now, the second appealable order is an order under section 91 and 92 refusing to grant leave to file a suit of the nature referred to under 91-92. So, we learned under section 91-92 that these are public interest litigations where the leave of the court is sought, where number one, advocate general is approached filing a suit for public nuisance and charities, public charities, or two or more persons with the leave of the court. So when leave is refused or when advocate general refuses to come, the parties may approach the court. First, before presentation of the plaint, a leave must be obtained under section 91-92. When the leave is refused, is an appealable order. Appealable order under the provisions of section 104. Now, before this, in the city of Bombay, the suits under section 91-92 are filed in the district court, namely original side of the Bombay High Court. Now, original side of the Bombay High Court, for example, rejecting the application under section 91-92. Now, you have to file an appeal. Now, some of the provisions, they say that here, the provisions of CPC are not applicable to the High Court. High Court has its got own rules. Now, because the rules are that your letters patent, when you open letters patent clause 15 of the Bombay, I'll let you know, the appeal is maintainable only against an order where there's a judgment is rendered. Can you open letters patent Bombay and Calcutta? Bombay, Madras, Calcutta is together. Letters patent Bombay clause 15. It says, clause 15.
So are these the rule or what exactly are these?
Let us patent Bombay, you know, because the suits are filed in the Bombay High Court, Bombay, Calcutta, Madras, in the original site under clause 12 of the let us patent. Let us patent clause 12. This I discussed with you while filing the suit. Clause 12 is the suit. Yes. Okay. You have to obtain the leave of the court when the defendants are. This is akin to section 20 of the Code of Civil Procedure and section 9. Now, an appeal, this is a very important provision. Please note that here. The Bombay High Court original site, Bombay, Calcutta, Madras, all these three high courts are established at the same time. They have original jurisdiction. In India, only few high courts have got original jurisdiction. All high courts do not have it. Okay? So, the suits are filed invoking clause 12. Before a single judge, the suits are filed. It is a trial court. Now, suppose, for example, you filed a suit under section 91-92 before a single judge of the Bombay High Court, invoking clause 12. Your application is rejected. Then your appeal is filed not under the CPC, clause 15 Kolia. Clause 15, appeal to the High Court from the judges of the court. And we see, doth further ordain that the appeal shall be filed to the High Court for judicature Bombay from the judgment not being the judgment passed. Now it uses the word judgment. It doesn't use the word order or it doesn't use the word decree. Kindly note that here. Now the issue before these, one of the matters before the High Court was that when an interlocutory application is rejected, the High Court does not have power to entertain appeal under clause 15 because an interlocutory application, for example, appointment of a receiver and order of injunction, they are not judgment, they are mere orders, interlocutory order. Judgment means, according to a single judge, a final decree, it is only against a final decree an appeal lies. Now that issue has now been resolved by the Supreme Court in one of the leading judgments that is known as Shah Babulal Khimji's case, AIR 1981 Bombay. Just kindly open Shah Babulal Khimji's case. Shah Babulal Bhimji versus Jayabin Kania. It's 81 Supreme Court. Shah Babulal Khimji. This is a three bench judgment rendered by the bench of Fazal Ali, Murtaza Fazal Ali, Vardarajan and Justice A.N. Sen. A landmark judgment which is holding the field. Because there were conflicting opinion, the Madras High Court took the view that here, the expression judgment also includes interlocutory order, the provisions of section 104 and order 43 applicable. The Bombay High Court had held that here, the provisions of section 104 and order 43 CPC are not applicable to Bombay High Court. Suits and application, appeal cannot be filed. But the Supreme Court has resolved in this controversy. The provisions of section 104 and order 43 are applicable to the High Court in the latest patent. And accordingly, all interlocutory orders which are affecting the party's rights are appealable in the High Court. Okay? Remember this judgment when you are coming to know. Okay? This is a landmark judgment. It is still holding the field. So pursuant to this judgment, because there was discussion that earlier, since the Bombay High Court has got its own original site rules and some of the provisions like section 117 CPC tell that the provisions are not applicable. But here the Supreme Court took the view that the provisions of clause 15 are not repugnant to the provisions of CPC. So wherever there is no conflict between CPC and the High Court rules, and the CPC is made applicable. Okay, that is the ratio. Now the next order which is made appealable is here, section 95, order under section 95. Now, order 95, we learn the supplemental proceedings under section 94, CPC. 94 and 95, where the court passes interlocutory order. We learned it here. When you open section 95, you will come to know that court passes an order of compensation when the order of attachment and injunction has been obtained by the other side by suppression of material fact incorrectly. Now, this order of compensation is made appealable under 104. Okay, these are the order. Then the next clause is that here, an order made under the rules from which an appeal is expressly allowed by the rules. Now, the rule here is, now for the purpose of rule, you have to see order 43. Kindly open order 43. Now, order 43 is a comprehensive provision, deals with provision for appeal from orders for various interlocutory orders, orders which are affecting the parties and not all orders. Now, for example, see that you took out and you filed a suit in the Bombay High Court and took out a notice of motion for appointment of a receiver or injunction which was rejected, you can come and appeal, file AO in the Bombay High Court. Similarly, in the Bombay High Court original side, you filed a suit for appointment of a receiver, injunction rejected by the court, then you can file an appeal under the provisions of Order 43. And as regards small causes court is concerned, they also have power, they can also invoke this provision under Order 43, apart from the fact that they have their own procedure. Now, let us see what are the orders. Now, appeal is a creature of the statute. As a matter of right, nobody can file it. No litigant can file appeal if it is not provided for. The statute must specifically provide the right of appeal, then only appeal lies. Otherwise, no appeal lies. Now, what are the appeals which are provided? Let us cursorily go through and which you have gone through. Number one, appeal from orders. An appeal shall lie from the following orders under the provisions of section 104. Namely, one, an order under rule 10 of order 7, written a plain to be presented to the proper court, except under rule 10A CPC. Now, we had learned that here, when a suit is filed by the plaintiff, defendant can take up the plea that the honorable court has no jurisdiction. Formerly in Maharashtra, the provision was section 9A, where the court can frame preliminary issue. Similarly, under order 14 subclause 2A, the court may decide the issue of jurisdiction as a preliminary issue. Now, while deciding the issue, the court comes to the conclusion that it has no jurisdiction, it will return the plain to the plaintiff under order 7, rule 11. Now, this order of returning the plain or not returning the plain is made appealable specifically under the first clause. Okay? Is it clear to you? Anybody has any doubt, please ask me. Now, the second order which is sought to be challenged is here. B is deleted. Now, C. An order under rule 9 of order 9 rejecting an application in case of open to appeal for an order to set aside dismissal of order. Under order 9, you learn that appearance of the parties and consequences of non-appearance. When the plaintiff doesn't appear after the filing of the suit, defendant only appears after filing written statement. Under order 9, rule 8, the suit can be dismissed. When a suit is dismissed, we learn that your second suit is barred. Plaintiff is precluded from filing a second suit. Now, what is the remedy available to the plaintiff? To make an application for restoration within 30 days. Now, if the application for restoration is dismissed, allowed or rejected, and it's an appealable order under order 43, okay, clause B, clause C. Now, Now C, C you have seen. Yeah, D now, an order under Rule 13 of Order 9, rejecting an application in case of appeal in order to set aside the decree passed. Now here is a case under Order 9, the plaintiff appears and the defendant doesn't appear. When the defendant doesn't appear, under the provisions of Order 9, Rule 11, the court passes an ex parte decree. Now the remedy of the defendant is twofold. Either he can apply for setting aside the decree under order by taking out application under Order 9, Rule 13, within 30 days, showing sufficient cause as to what prevented him from appearing, or he has a right to file an appeal under Section 96. Now, for example, he chose the alternate remedy of filing an application under Order 9, Rule 13, within 30 days, and showed a reason before the court that he was prevented from coming to the court on account of the fact that he was suffering from malaria or he was out of India, XYZ. The court did not accept his explanation. Application stood rejected. When application rejected, that the defendant has a right of appeal under Order 43, Clause D. Okay? An AO can be filed because this is an order substantially affecting the rights of the defendant. It is not a mere interlocutory order which is insignificant. It is very significant because the defendant is debarred from participating. Okay, next order is an order under Order 21, Rule 11. This is Rule 11, execution application. When Order 21, may execution application is filed and rejected by the court, and you can come in appeal before the court. This is after decree is passed, you make an application for application for execution is filed, you know, under 21-11, or that is within 2 years. If an application is filed after 2 years, that procedure comes into play under Order 21, Rule 22. Okay? Then next is the, yes.
If I am filing an order to set aside a decree and also filing an appeal simultaneously, is that maintainable?
No, you have to withdraw one of them. Two proceedings, parallel proceedings are not maintainable. Either you invoke the provisions of Order 9, Rule 13, or you go in appeal under Section 96, because it's an appeal from decree. You cannot have both. Okay?
Sir.
Yeah. Yeah. Next is, please see that an order under Order 34, Rule 21, an objection to the draft of a decree for an endorsement. Now, Order 21, Rule 31 deals with the provision where this is an execution stage. Under Order 31, the plaintiff can apply to the court that a decree for execution of a document or endorsement on the negotiable instrument. Now, what it is a decree for execution of a document mean? Suppose husband and wife, they have filed a matrimonial suit, settle the filing consent terms. One of the condition in the consent terms was that the husband will provide separate accommodation to the wife by buying one bedroom hall kitchen, maybe in Borivali also. So in view of the consent term matter I dispose of, the husband does not honor. So the wife can file an execution application under 2134 for a direction that he may be directed to execute document. Okay, that is one thing. Or endorsement or negotiable instrument. For example, a bill of exchange or a promissory note, the plaintiff or defendant have failed to execute it or sign it. That is one provision where execution can take place. If the court refuses this order, for whatever reason, it is made appealable under the provisions of Order 43, Rule 1, Clause I. Okay? Then Order 72...
Sir, Ashish, quick question, sir. So the example jo aapne diya for the husband and wife, where will that be filed? Will that be filed in the family court or in the small causes court?
Now it is a family court. Now it is a family court. Formerly it was a city civil court and Bombay High Court, depending upon the agreement. But execution application, the family court has no process. You can come to the Bombay High Court. Please note that.
Thank you, sir.
You can come to the Bombay High Court. Next is order is which is appealable is a order 21 rule 72. 72 checker 72 mean execution of a decree. Under this provision, the decree holder cannot himself purchase it. A very interesting provision. Suppose decree is passed in your favor, you are a plaintiff. At the time of the execution, you yourself cannot file it. Some purchasers maybe have to be third parties. The reason behind it, 72, is that the decree holder cannot bid without the permission of the court. Suppose decree is passed, it is kept for sale. The court invites auction purchasers and people to give a bid. So maybe 5-6 persons may give a different bid. The property may attract substantial amount. If the judgment decree, that is plaintiff himself said that I would like to bid, I am paying, he will give a smaller amount. He may not give a fair price to the defendant. That is why the court in its discretion says that here, normally the plaintiff decree holder is not permitted to bid at the auction sale without the leave of the court. It is only when there are no purchasers in the market, when nobody is coming forward, then the decree holder can make application. My lord, I will purchase this property for so and so rupees or any amount that your lordship may kindly forget it. Then if that order is passed, the judgment debtor defendant can file an appeal under the provisions of order 43, rule 1, clause J. Similarly, rule 92. Now rule 92 may kindly be seen. Order 21, rule 92 deals with a situation when sale becomes absolute or sale is set aside. So when execution take place, movable property or immovable property is put up for sale. When put up for sale, the court passes a decree. For example, take in a decree for foreclosure or a foreclosure that under order 34, the mortgager has not able to arrange money. If he is not able to arrange money, the court passes a preliminary decree. In the preliminary decree, he is directed to deposit the money. If he doesn't do that, the court passes a final decree. Then bids are invited from general public and the sale becomes absolute. In that here, there is a provision here. When the sale becomes absolute, no suit shall be filed to set aside the decree order under this rule. Kindly see that. 92.2.3 ke andar, you cannot be permitted to file a separate suit. Okay. That is, when this order is passed, it is made appealable under the provisions of order 43, clause J. Okay. This is executive. Then come to JA, an order rejecting application made under subrule 1 of 106 of order 21. Now, order 21, rule 106. Deals with the setting aside ex parte decree. Now you learned here when obstruction has been caused to a decree, then the plaintiff decree holder takes out application for removal of obstruction under section 97. We learned it. Then under section 97, may obstruction notice is taken out, then that is heard like a suit under section under rule 101. We discuss it here. Now under rule 101, when the order which is passed by the court and no separate suit lies, we learnt it here. Only in the application, the court can decide all issues, including the fact that the court does not have jurisdiction. Maybe a court of limited jurisdiction. It can pass vast orders. And that order becomes a res judicata. We learnt it under the provisions of section 11. Now, when this order is passed under the provisions of 101 and the defendant does not appear, means that obstruction is does not appear, the court can pass ex parte decree. Now, Rule 106 is more or less analogous or akin to the provisions of Order 9, Rule 13. In Order 9, Rule 13, the defendant makes an application for setting aside the ex parte decree. Now, under 106, the obstructionist who remain absent, against whom ex parte order is passed, he makes an application. When his application is rejected for restoration, then it's an appealable order under the provisions of Order 43, Rule 1, clause number JA. Please note that. An appeal lies against this order. Is that clear to you? Then the item number K, clause number K deals with an order under Rule 9 of Order 22 refusing to set aside the abatement or dismissal of suit. Now, yesterday only we learned when the plaintiff dies or defendant dies, heirs are required to be brought within 90 days under Article 120 of the Limitation Act. If the heirs are not brought on record of the plaintiff or defendant, the suit abates. Abates means stand dismissed as good as. Now, the application for setting aside the abatement would lie under Order 22, Rule 9, within 60 days under Article 121. Mansi, please open Article 121 of the Limitation Act.
So only 10 minutes are remaining.
Yeah, we'll just discuss this point. I'll ask questions. Yeah, because the student should know, because since we are also having Limitation Act, you should know under what provision you make application for setting aside the condonation of delay for setting aside the abatement. Article 121, Ligia. Got it? Under the same code, for an order for setting aside abatement, 60 days. To bring the heirs on record under Article 20, 90 days. And if you don't bring them on record, your suit abates. For setting aside the abatement, 60 days. Ye application aapka reject ho gaya samjhe. The trial court has rejected the application. It's an appealable order because it has got a repercussion to the plaintiff or defendant. If the plaintiff suit is abated, mean it is dismissed as good as. So plaintiff has to make the application that this honorable court be pleased to set aside the abatement. Number one, in the above suit, the defendant is reported dead. The advocate of the defendant has not given intimation under Order 22, Rule 10A. I do not know. It has come to my knowledge that the defendant expired maybe around 1 year back. My knowledge is only recent. The suit has been abated. That this honorable court be pleased to set aside the abatement and allow me to bring the heirs and legal representatives of the defendant. Suppose, for example, if there are no legal heirs of the defendant, what is the course? Then the course is under Order 22, Rule 4A, the plaintiff has to make an application that the administrator general be appointed as the person to defend. Now, please open Order 22, Rule 4A. Mohini, Order 22, Rule 4A. Order 22, Rule 4A. Yeah. See here, under this year, Administrator General is brought on record to represent the estate of the deceased person or the defendant. Why? Because you know that under the doctrine of the Indian Constitution, I think Article 292, I think there is a doctrine of escheat or bona vacantia applies. When there are no heirs and legal representatives of a person to a property, the property will be taken over by the government. Mansi, you can open that provisions of the Constitution, bona vacantia. That is, I think, Article 290, if I'm not mistaken, 290. 296? Yes, Article 296. You should know as a young lawyer and a student of law, when the plaintiff or defendant dies without leaving any heirs or legal representatives, the property will be escheated to the government. This is called doctrine of bona vacantia. Please note that. When this is invoked, then that is the provisions of Order 22, Rule 4A come into play. Under the Indian Administrator General's Act, an administrator, an officer of the court, is appointed to safeguard the property. Okay? If it is a plaintiff, is a landlord, he can get back the property. Suppose if the plaintiff is XYZ and who has no right title interest, the property will go to the government. The defendant having some semblance of a legal right, the administrator will take it charge. That is the provision. Then normally administrator is appointed to safeguard the property and it is not encroached upon. That is the provision. Now, when this application under Order 22, Rule 9 is rejected, so we learned it here, appealable order. Anybody has any question, quickly ask me before I turn to other topics.
Sir Ashish here, sir.
Yes,
sir. Does this have to be filed only for the defendants, or does it the same thing apply for the plaintiff also if the plaintiff dies?
If the plaintiff dies, the suit also totally abates if he doesn't do that here. In the case of defendant, abates. His legal heirs have to come on record. Otherwise, the administrator general will come on record. The court will appoint somebody else because the property has to be taken care of.
Yes, sir. And sir, does the matter have to come on board for it to abate, or does it abate automatically from the date of the death of the plaintiff?
It automatically abates from the date. If the matter come up on board, it is immaterial whether the matter was on board or not on board, has come up or not come. From the date death, it abates. But your application for setting aside from the date of the knowledge of the death, please note that here, under Article 120 and 121, the date of knowledge. Okay, you may take up the plea that I mentioned to you under Order 22, Rule 10A. It is the duty of the pleader of the party to intimate to the court that my client is dead, because as a plaintiff, you are not going to dream where is the defendant. He may be in America, London, touring. He is dead and gone. How do you know? You will not know. At least the advocate is in touch. Advocate is the agent of the client. He is in touch. He informs him the progress of the matter from day to day. On so and so, the matter appeared on court. The court has been pleased to frame issues. You are requested to come and see me for preparation of the evidence. So the advocates are constantly in touch with the client. So the advocates are presumed to be having knowledge of a death. So the advocate has to give intimation to the court that my client is dead and these are the legal heirs and legal representatives, and the plaintiff is at liberty to take appropriate steps in the matter. If despite knowledge he doesn't take up this step, the suit abates. Okay?
So then a condonation of delay has to be filed immediately if the time is elapsed.
Because you have a right to file the application within 90 days from the date of intimation, not from the date of the death. Because the advocate is giving you intimation after 1 year. You did not know. So you make it next day application. Okay? Intimation is given to you. My client is dead about 2 years ago. You had no knowledge. Your knowledge is today itself. The advocate makes an intimation to the honorable court that my client is reported dead today. So you are from the date of the knowledge, you make application. So there is no delay as such here. Assuming there's a delay, the court says that take out application under Order 22, Rule 9 for setting aside the abatement. Okay?
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Anybody has any question before I proceed? Mansi, how much time is left out now for this meeting?
2 minutes.
2 minutes. Anybody has any question? Yeah. Now, the next is the next order which is appealable is item number I check KJ. I may an order under Rule 10 of Order 22 giving or refusing to give leave. Under Rule 10 of Order 22. Now Order 22, Rule 10, what is it is? Have you forgotten about it? What is the leave the court grants it here? Anybody knows? Under Order 22, Rule 10, the court grants leave, that is a procedure in case of assignment to find out. Now, assignment takes place. Suppose during the pendency of a suit, plaintiff has sold the right title interest to Mr. X. X is required to be brought on record as a party plaintiff. But he cannot come straight away. He has to take the leave of the court. Please note that. So under the Transfer of Property Act, you have learned what is assignment. Assignment is a transfer of interest, isn't it? Suppose during the pendency of a suit, A has filed a suit against B. A, the landlord, has filed a suit against tenant for the, on the ground of subletting or a non-payment of rent. So during the pendency of a suit, the landlord owner sells the property to Mr. X. So the ground of eviction continues against the new landlord. It is not so that year. So the new landlord, who is called an assignee, he can make an application to the court. I may be permitted to come on record